The Korg iM1 is a realization of the classic Korg M1 workstation. It's a full multi-timbral synth offering rich classic sounds from the 80s and 90s. We've had a number of users ask us about using GeoShred to control the Korg iM1 app. This is a brief overview of how to set up GeoShred and iM1 to work together. Starting out, for the iM1 side, you will want to turn on background audio. The iM1 supports two types of performances. Multi-performances, where each voice is assigned to a different MIDI channel. Multi is going to work best with GeoShred when it's operating as a multi-channel controller. And Combi, which responds to a single MIDI channel, but you can layer and split several different voices. Combi can be used as well with GeoShred, but because Combi presets respond to only a single MIDI channel, independent expression is limited. Let's start with multi. On the GeoShred side, you'll want to choose the multi-MIDI configuration from Menu MIDI. Under the DIN, choose the I1 MIDI port and be sure to choose MIDI out. Here is an example multi-preset in IM1. Let's verify that it's responding to MIDI correctly. Note that you will need to double tap when selecting a voice for a part. Note that it's also necessary to set the pitch bend range for each part to be 12. This is so that the IM1 will respond correctly to GeoShred's slide mode. Now let's verify that it's working correctly. Here's the piano on all six parts. And let's do a pitch bend from here. That's correct. And now let's do pitch bends in opposite directions. That's how we know that the IM1 is configured correctly to work with the multi-channel MIDI controller. Because each string in GeoShred can send to a different channel, it's possible for your performance to be multi-timbral by putting a different voice on each part. Now let's look at Combi. Here's a Combi voice on MIDI channel 1, which is a layer of four different voices, each configured differently. On the GeoShred side, we're going to want to choose the single channel MIDI configuration. And once again, we'll verify that MIDI out is turned on and we're sending to the IM1. It's also necessary to, again, set the pitch bend range to be 12. Let's try playing it. It sounds great. Note that we can slide on a single note. However, if we try to slide two notes, the pitch bends will fight each other. This is because Combi presets are on a single MIDI channel. Good luck with your iM1 creations, and please send us a link to anything amazing that you make.